Hey, what's up everybody? How you doing? Welcome back to Carpool Gaming and another Outriders video. Nice. Today, ladies and gentlemen, I'm bringing to you an amazing in-game Technomaster Pestilent build capable of soloing carrying anybody through any content in Outriders. So let's get started with this lovely build guide. So if at any given time you found this video helpful, just a little bit entertaining, please by all means follow, like, and subscribe on all social media platforms, but especially on YouTube. Why? It helps these videos get out there in the YouTube algorithm, and I'm able to do more giveaways, ladies and gentlemen, just like this giveaway I have going right now. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, we have a new giveaway for Resident Evil Village. Links down below in the description. Now, you clicked on this video because you wanted to check out my in-game Technomaster build. Well, it is pretty freaking amazing. Capable of soloing all of the content right here in Outriders, CT-15, super easy. Millions of damage when you're rolling solo, and guess what? When that scales up, when you're playing with 2 to 3 players, and we all know it scales up, well, you'll be able to still do amazing damage even if your rounds are down. That's right, as you can see right here, everything is down and I'm still able to get hundreds of thousands of damage with this build. It's pretty good. Helping people, soloing content, you can do it all. Let's start off with the skills for this Technomaster build. Now, we're going to be using Shrapnel, Blighted Turret, and Blighted Rounds. We're going to be spamming Shrapnel and Blighted Turret and keep our Blighted Rounds up. Shrapnel, well, it's a proximity mine that explodes, dealing over 40,000 damage, and it also interrupts enemies as well. Now, we also are going to be keeping up our Blighted Turret. Now, this is an automatic turret that deals a little over 2600 damage. It also inflicts toxic on enemies and it slows them down over time. It's going to deal a little bit of damage, and even when we don't have our blighted rounds up, we're still going to be getting that amazing damage because they're still going to have that toxic effect. And then last but not least, we all know blighted rounds, pretty cool. Fill your magazine up with decay infused bullets that's going to inflict toxics on enemies in a small radius around them and deal 50% of that toxic damage. The skill, yeah, it's pretty good. We're going to keep this up pretty much indefinitely, but if in any given case it does go down the way I have the build set up, you still got yourself covered with a lot of damage. Next, we have the skill tree. Now, we're going to go top tree pestilence build on this, and we're going to be stacking our damage, as you can see right here, long range weapon damage, skill leech, and also weapon leech as well. As long as we get our kills, we're going to get healed, and that's what we're going to do. Our first note is BR8 impactor for increased 8% weapon damage. Sour Decay is going to decrease our skill cooldowns by additional 15%. We also have Drill Coating for armor piercing, 10%. Havoc Nexus increases our critical damage by 15%. Exposing Toxins is going to inflict vulnerability. If you don't know, that's going to increase our damage by 25%. And Marks for Execution, additional 40% more effective. I do notice a difference in damage, so definitely keep that on. Nitrogen Castle is going to decrease our distance considered to be a long range. We have increased weapon damage, cannonade. This is pretty cool. Whenever we throw our grenade, we also are going to get an additional 30% damage for us and our allies as well for a whopping 10 seconds. So not only helping you, you're helping your teammates. Another nitrogen castle, another purge for more toxic damage as well. Another note for weapon damage, Assault Master, this is key. We're going to have increased weapon damage for assaults by 20%. That includes assault rifle, light machine guns, submachine guns, and double guns. So yeah, you can use a lot of different weapons with this, and it just increases the fun. We also have assault definitely increase assault weapon damage, drill coating, another armor piercing, two sides of the power. You got a yin and yang kind of effect. Increased damage received from all sources by 15%, but you're going to be dealing an extra 20% damage. So as long as you kill, we're going to get our heals back, so it's cool. Sharpshooter increases long range weapon damage by 30%. Clip size is going to get increased by 50% with that note right there. We also have Purge. It's going to increase more damage by 15% to enemies affected by Toxic. And last but not least, Empowering Antenna. Whenever we throw those ability ups, we're going to get additional 40% weapon damage for 10 seconds for us and our allies. Now, let's go over the weapons. Now, this isn't essential, but it kind of is holding the build together, kind of, sort of. The Earthborn Renegade Assault Rifle. Now, this is a weapon you can get from getting the DLC, the Hellrangers DLC. So, if you don't have this, there is still some alternatives that you can get. But essentially, in order to get this weapon, you want to go into your stash if you have that DLC. And pick up this weapon, and then we're going to basically re-roll it. And hopefully you can get that damage up to 375, upgrade it to level 50. And yeah, you got yourself probably one of the best weapons in the game. Although there is some alternatives, as you can see right here, that I have picked up that work just as good as this. Now you see I'm running Fortress over Killing Spree. Killing Spree is a great mod. You can get up to 75% extra damage, right? Killing shots increase damage by 25% for 20 seconds. It deteriorates with time, stacks up to 3 kills. I went with Fortress because I'm going to get that 43% base damage. So if and when our blighted rounds do go down, well, then we'll be able to still get excellent damage, as you can see right here. Showed this a little bit earlier. This is when everything is down. Blighted rounds is down, grenade is down, turret is down, and I'm still able to get excellent damage. So next up, let's go with the armor mods that we have for this build. Now for all of our armor pieces, we're going to try to hit firepower damage, long range damage, and close range damage. If you do that, you have an extra 50% of long range and close range damage. For our mods, we have Sharp Eye, killing enemies while aiming down a sight, grants you 16,089 firepower damage for 20 seconds, stacks up to 3 times, and then crits that. Critical shots build up to 5 seconds, a stacking effect that grants you 3,500 anomaly power and 7,725 firepower bonus, stacks up to 5 times. If you're looking for Sharp Eye, I found it off of Sergio's Beret, but I think there are other different legendaries that you can get this from as well, just don't remember offhand. For our chest piece, we went with Damage Absorber and Dum Dum Bullets. Damage Absorber is excellent. It's going to double our armor and 10% extra resistance. It's key. It's going to help our survivability tremendously. And then we have our pants, our lower armor. This is the only piece I don't have close range damage, but we have Critical Analysis. Blighted rounds increase our critical damage by 15%, and Move Groove. Moving increases our anomaly power by 9,000, firepower by 12,871. Both of these are excellent mods. Move Groove can actually be swapped out for a few other mods if you want to. And then Trick Up the Sleeve, we nailed it on the gloves. And we have Blighted Rounds. When the skill is active, killing shots grants us 30% extra bullets in a mag. And then Euthanizer deal 25% more damage against enemies that are afflicted by Toxic. They're always going to be afflicted by Toxic. So yeah, that's what's up. Trick Up the Sleeve can be swapped out. So yeah, this build can still be improved. But if you're looking for Euthanizer, it drops off the Plague Sour Hands. These are legendaries that you can get randomly when you are running CT-15s or any other lower levels. Good luck out there. May Orange Jesus be with you. For our legs, we have Captain Hunter. Increases our damage by at least by a whopping 25%. Must have on any build. Then Bloodless, killing shots increases your firepower by 17,505. Stacks up to 3 times and deteriorates every 10 seconds. So as you can see, we're stacking that firepower. And yeah, it's excellent. If you're looking for Captain Hunter, dude drops off of a couple different legendaries, but you can get it off of the Gauntlets of the Cannonball, which you actually can get from doing the hunt. So this one is actually a little bit easier to obtain. And yeah, this build is excellent. Capable of soloing and carrying anybody through CT-15. I hope you have a good time putting this build together. But for right now, that's pretty much going on for the video. Hope you truly enjoyed it. Once again, if you are new to this channel, hey, how you doing? Welcome. Don't forget to subscribe right here at Carpool Gaming. I upload a wide variety of videos ranging from updates, tips and tricks, guides and news from a whole bunch of different games like Outriders and a whole lot more. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to enter into that contest for Resident Evil Village. Good luck is going to end in about a week. So yeah. Hope you having a wonderful day. With your help watching these videos, I'm able to give back more. So thank you everybody for all your love and your support. And as always, I'll be seeing y'all in the next one. Later.